Hi, my name is Gary Raposa, and I'm an application engineer here at Keysight Technologies. Today, I want to talk to you about our IntegraVision Power Analyzer, model number PA2201A. And specifically, I want to focus on the AC power disturbance measurement capability that's built into this product. It can show AC waveforms, just like an oscilloscope, the voltage, the current, and the power, and we'll take a look at that in just a moment here. First, I want to show you that what I'll be testing is this DC power supply. It's a 200 watt power supply, 20 volts, 10 amps. In fact, it's running at 20 volts and 10 amps right now. The 10 amps is flowing into one of our electronic loads. And the AC input from this DC power supply is coming from one of our AC sources here down on the bottom. All of these things are available from Keysight as well. In fact, I'll be using our AC source here. This is a 6813B in order to create the power disturbances that I'll be showing you here today. Now, we'll be measuring power disturbances on this DC power supply, but the product that you will be designing will also potentially be subjected to power disturbances because no AC line is perfect. Could be thunderstorms, could create surges, or could be a sag in voltage, there could be a dropout in AC cycles, there could be a brownout, there could be noise on the line, so all different power line disturbances could be on the line that your product is plugged into, and you just want to make sure that your product behaves well when it's subjected to those types of power disturbances. So, we'll be doing those measurements with the power analyzer. Now, again, this PA2201A is a two-channel analyzer. Each channel has voltage input and current inputs, and it calculates the power from the voltage and current inputs. So the top screen, the top part of the screen here is showing the voltage waveforms. The middle part right now is showing the current, and the bottom is showing the power. This is the yellow is the AC input voltage, the AC input current, and the AC input power. This is also a touch screen, so it's very easy to change anything on here. I can go to here and it works just like an oscilloscope. I can change the time per division. I can change the volts per division here very simply. The voltage is up and down. If I switch over to the current, I can change the amps per division. And of course I can go to the power and I can change the power per division here as well. So, let's take a quick look at a surge of voltage and see how our power supply output behaves when subjected to a surge of AC input voltage. So let's take a look at what happens when a surge of voltage, AC input voltage, occurs on the AC input of the DC power supply. We're going to see what happens to the DC output. So first, right now it's running and it's triggering off of the AC input. On the back of here, there are external input triggers, so I've got the AC source set up to send a trigger signal when I create the surge with the source to trigger the IntegraVision power analyzer. So let me make sure that this is paying attention to the right trigger. I go to trigger, source, from voltage one, I'm going to say external. So now to look for the external trigger on the back. And I'm going to clear this display. And we're going to get a single sweep here. I've got this set up with my computer to program the AC source to do a single surge up. I hit the button here and see if we capture that. Well, there it is. So the yellow waveform on the top is the surge of voltage, as you can see, and the green waveform also on the top is a disturbance in the DC output. So there is a disturbance that occurred as a result of that surge of voltage. You can even still see the current and the power and what happens to the current and the power when that surge occurs also. Now, I want to run that again. I'm going to change this display and let's make it so that we look at only at the voltage because that's really what we're interested in. And there's various displays we have to choose from here. So right now I picked just the voltage. I'm going to repeat the surge and see if we can capture that. And again, there it is, the voltage is surging up. And after the surge is done and the voltage comes back to a nominal value is when the disturbance occurs. So I'm gonna stop this so it doesn't accidentally sweep here. And you're gonna see I can also use the touch screen to zoom in on this part of the waveform here. If I hit that and hit horizontal waveform zoom, we get even a better view of what that surge really looks like. And I could zoom even further on that if I really want to. We can undo those zooms if we want to take a look at it from here as well. So it's a very capable product, very useful in taking a look at power disturbances. And in this particular case, we saw that the output voltage is affected by a surge and then back down to nominal. So let's take a look at one other power disturbance. Actually, we'll look at a sag next. Once again, we'll take a look at a sag in the AC input voltage and see how the output performs. Again, I'm producing the sag with our AC source and my computer control here. See if we're set up to go. Yep. So there's the sag in voltage, goes from about 120 volts down to about 98 volts. And you can see again the green, the yellow is the AC input, the green is the DC output. And you can see that there is a disturbance on the output. Once again, I can kind of zoom in on that with this if I want to take a closer look, and I could get even closer with it zooming in further and take a look at what the output does. I can undo those if I want. But again, we see that the DC output of this power supply is affected by a sag in voltage. Now, this sag is beyond the AC input limits of the supply. I did that on purpose to create some type of an output disturbance. We'll try another one here. We'll do next a cycle dropout to see what happens with an AC cycle dropout. So let's take a look at how the output performs when subjected to a single cycle dropout. So a single cycle on the AC line will disappear, and we'll see what the green output waveform does. So I've got my computer program set to do that, and I'll hit the start transient. And we'll see what happens here. Yep, so as you can see, the single cycle disappeared, the yellow AC input, and the green is the output set at 20 volts, 10 amps, and AC coupled here we're at 1 volt per division, so the voltage dropped about 1 division, 2 divisions, almost 2.5 divisions. It dropped about 2.5 volts and came back within, this is 10 milliseconds per division. So, we could actually measure how much that dropped by turning the cursors on. And I can move those up and down with the cursor knob here. Put this down around the bottom of that peak, and we can see on the side here. Let's see, take a moment just to find that on here. So, that's on the voltage of channel 1, so we'll change it to the voltage of channel 2. That will make much more sense. And now I can put that over here, and I got, about minus 2.4 volts is the transient for the output voltage on a single cycle dropout. Okay, now here's another really interesting AC power disturbance we can capture on a single shot basis. So we can look at the AC inrush current of that DC power supply. So once again, I have my program set up to just go from 0 volts up to an AC input, and I'm going to do that right now, and the AC should come on. It was sitting at 0, and it went up, and you can see this peak of inrush current that flows in. In fact, we can turn the cursors on to measure that and move that up and down with this knob and see that that peak of inrush current, this is at about 5 amps per division, so 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and sure enough, 29.9 amps. It says on there. So you can very easily capture a single shot with the IntegraVision Power Analyzer to see what the inrush current is. Let's take a look at one last waveform on the IntegraVision Power Analyzer. And this is a really interesting one also. This is the I squared T rating measurement. So I squared T is a rating on a fuse, but well, let's get it on the screen first and I'll talk more about it in just a moment. So I'm going to start a transient that will get the AC inrush current on here again. So there's the AC inrush of my DC power supply. So this is just amps. And now I can turn the math on, and I've got the math set up here to do this I1 times I1. So that's I squared. And then I have another function of math that is the integral of the first math function. So that's the integral of I squared. So that means it's I squared t. So this will be a measurement now of I squared t. So let me take that measurement again, start this transient, and we'll actually see the purple waveform appear here, which is the math function, and that's our I squared t measurements. Now let me just move this down a little bit. Let's see, 1.5 amps sounds like a good place for the offset. And the scale is 500 milliamps squared seconds per division. So we've got about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 divisions and a half an amp squared second per division. So five, that's about 2.5 amps squared seconds is the peak here. Now, what is that measurement? Fuses have two ratings. They have the main rating for the fuse, and the AC input fuse on this power supply happens to be a 3-amp fuse, but it also has an I squared T rating of 38 amp squared seconds. So this is way, way below that, and in no danger of blowing that fuse due to this peak of current that's much, much higher than the 3-amp rating, but it's there for just a short time. So again, for people who are familiar with amp squared second ratings on fuses, you'll know that this is a very, very useful measurement and very easy to make with the IntegraVision Power Analyzer. So we've seen today how the Keysight IntegraVision Power Analyzer is able to show you how your product will behave as a result of AC disturbances that are on the line. In this case, we took a look at one of our DC power supplies. We took a look at how the output behaves when subjected to a surge in voltage, to a sag in voltage, to cycle dropouts, to also, we saw what happened with the AC inrush current, and even an I squared T measurement at the very end here. So I hope you can see how this product can help you design your products and help you make them as immune as possible to power line disturbances to help satisfy your customers.